The following is a presentation of University of Utah Hockey.
Utah Hockey Game Day Live. Tonight, the Utes look to get above 500 for the first time since September as they take on the Arizona State Sun Devils, the Division II squad here in Salt Lake City tonight. And it's here live on Utah Hockey Game Day Live. Good evening, everybody, and welcome into tonight's broadcast. So glad you guys can join us. Matt Coma alongside Boz Echevarri. And Boz, a little trip back to D2 before a big weekend against Minot State next weekend.
Yeah, well, I mean, you see this all the time in college football where teams play lower division teams to get things right. And to get things in order, that's kind of what we have tonight. Of course, Utah kind of on the bad end of a couple of tight games this month, but an opportunity to work on some things tonight.
So a chance to tune up as we go to Minot next weekend. That's the number two team in the country, as we see in our updated ACHA D1 rankings that came out on Wednesday. Iowa State and Minot State number one and number two, and guess what? They're both on Utah's schedule.
Yeah, you know what? That's you play the schedule you're given. That's how this sport works.
As you see the rest of the top 25 there on your screen, Syracuse and Arizona also still on Utah's remaining schedule. Colorado State's at 19. Arizona State, the team that we're going to see tonight, the D1 team, is now all the way up to 16th in the country. They beat Utah two weekends ago down in Tempe. Two close games between the Utes and Sun Devils. It's got to be a good point for the Utes, knowing that they have a couple of close games against top 25 opponents.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of this season is going to be a lot of confidence building and seeing where you're at compared to the rest of the top 25. But the fact that they played very close games against teams that are in the top 25, I think is a good coaching point and a great point to build off of going in the rest of the year.
There you see the rest of the top 25. No one on the bottom half on the Utah schedule as far as the bottom of the top 25. Utah still hasn't received any votes yet. They're still waiting for that first Division I win. As you mentioned, they're 4-0 in Division II against the D2 teams. They're 0-4 against the D1 teams.
Well, that's going to happen, especially when you make the jump, a lot of growing pains.
I mentioned that the Utes are 4-0 against the Division II teams so far. They had two games against D2 opponents last weekend. As the Utes went up to Logan last Saturday night, their last opponent, and it was the Utah State Aggies. They now lead the season series 2-0 with 2 games still left to play. That 5-2 win for the Utes up there in Logan. They extend their unbeaten streak over Utah State to 7 games now, spanning over the last 2.5 seasons. Chris Coma picked up the win. It's his 47th career win. It's a new Utah team record for the most career wins by a goaltender. Connor Meany and Alex King both had 2 goals for the Utes, and it was just a great performance all around for the Utes.
And it goes to number one. This program has had plenty of great goaltenders in the past couple of seasons, and I think for what Chris Coma is doing, it's really quite remarkable because of the level of competition he's doing it against, which I think is the best that this program has seen in its 10 years of existence.
All right, we're about a couple minutes to face off, so we'll step aside for one quick break. When we come back, we'll end your starting lineups, national anthem, and we'll get ready for puck drop. It's the Utes and the Sun Devils here on Utah Hockey Game Day Live. It's coming up next. Don't go anywhere. All right, hockey fans, welcome back. Getting ready for puck drop between Utah and Arizona State. Just the fourth meeting all time between this Utah team and the sole Division II team that we've seen from Arizona State at this level. We were talking beforehand with the coaches and stuff. We've seen a lot of incarnations of this ASU team. We've had a Division I team a couple times. You've seen the D2 team by itself. You've had a D2 Elite team, a D2 Pac-8 team, a D2 Maroon team. And now we're back to just a Division II team here for ASU. A lot of different teams down there in Tempe. But it just goes to show that something that not only Utah but the West, they try to strive to be this program that Arizona State has.
Yeah, Arizona State definitely the leading program in the Western states, considering the amount of levels that they have, spanning all the way to the varsity NCAA level. And that's this is exactly what schools want to be, is this Arizona State school. Granted, this is the Division II level, but this is the type of program that you want. You want players coming to your school to play in each level to work your way up, just the way that Arizona State has.
Absolutely. And you see with the NCAA, you have an NCAA team, you have a D1 team that's nationally ranked, you have a D2 team that's going to be ranked once the West rankings come out as well. Just shows that high caliber that Arizona State has. It's going to be a great contest here between, yes, it's a Division I game, against D1 versus D2 game, but it's going to be a good contest here.
A lot of these players from Arizona State, they could very well play on that Division I team. But we look at this, it should be a tune-up, but at the same time, I mean, it's a game that you need to play very hard.
All right, without further ado, we send it downstairs our public address announcer for tonight, Justin Long, for our starting lineups and national anthem.
Tonight's starting lineups, first for the Sunday, in goal, number 29, Paul Flores. 22, William Palmer. Right defense, number 26, Marcus Gordon. Left wing, number 28, Scott Farley. And center, number 12, A. Ward. Right wing, number 15, Aaron Burton. For your University of Utah State Utes, left defense, number 18, Cody West. Right defense, number 18, Kyle Petrie.
All right, hockey fans, getting ready for puck drop. In case you missed it, here are tonight's starting lineups brought to you by the Red Lion Hotel. First, for the visiting Arizona State Sun Devils, getting the start tonight is number 29, Oliver Borst. On defense, number 22, Will Parlin, and number 26, Marcus Velasco. In the forward line tonight, for ASU, number 14, Aaron Burden, number 12, Aiden Ward, and number 28, Scott Farr. As for the Utah Skeeting Utes, making his first appearance in goal this season is number 31, Jared Manzella. Had a 2-1 record as a rookie last season for Utah. He gets his first nod in the pipes tonight for Utah. Cody West and Guy Petrie on the blue line for the Utes. And then Connor Meany, Alex King, Josh Dangle, your starting line for the University of Utah here tonight.
As I
Teams meet at center ice. Utah's in the white uniforms tonight with the red trim and red helmets. They'll move left to right on your screens. ASU is in the black and yellow uniforms. They move right to left as the teams meet at center ice. Puck drop just moments away between Utah and Arizona State. First meeting of the season, and we are underway from Salt Lake City. Arizona State winning the opening faceoff as Will Parling gets it here to the near side, met by three Utes immediately. Now Connor Meany brings it into the zone, plays it to the far side, too far for Dangle to control. And we're underway here. Center pass to Alex King. His backhand shot goes wide. Now it's Connor Meany behind the net. Has two men in front. ASU got a stick on it. Now it bounces out to Scott Farr, one of the mainstays for this Division II squad. He's been part of the ASU Maroon and Pac-8 squads in the past. Now part of the Division II squad for this ASU team. 10 players from the Maroon squad are on this Division II team from last season.
It was a good team that was on that group. Those good players are actually up here.
Yeah, went to the Division or two national championship tournament, both the ASU Elite and Maroon squads last season. Both teams, not the outcome they wanted. They both of them didn't get out of pool play. Of course, ASU Elite losing to Florida Gulf Coast, the eventual national champions. ASU was in the pool B, I believe. As here come the Utes with Julian Cronin, who gets a turnover, but met by three Sun Devils. This team's still kind of just feeling it out here as a nice center pass breaks out Austin Mills. One-on-one with Lieberknight. He'll go to the far side, sends one in front off the skate of Barnes. Way into the corner. Now over to the far side, Mills tries to chip it down low. Stolen away by Meyer at the top of the zone. He'll bring it out himself. Zone blue line, plays the near side. Cronin takes a hit here on the near side by Andrew Pekinen. Comes into the near side as the Utes were able to send it all the way down. Meyer tied up down low. Fornelius helping out as he gains the puck. Plays it on top of the point for Pendle. Trying to go back down low. Stolen away by Mills. Played here to the near side. Quick touch back to Mills. Now it's 2-on-2. They'll send it into the Utah end and change. Almost 2 minutes gone here as a stretch pass turned over by ASU. Walking in with a shot is saved by Manzella, who holds on for his first save of the night as Garrett Anderson with a good opportunity for the Sun Devils.
Man, you know, this is a team that Utah should be comfortable with, seeing them multiple times at the Division II level, of course, being around them in the national championship tournament last year and the year before that. So not a game where you're completely unfamiliar with the players that are on the ice, but a game that you do need to establish your dominance.
Very disciplined team that Tate Green has got here for the ASU Elite ASU Division II squad here, as they don't take a lot of penalties. They play their system as they like to do. And that's what's been their success so far, and it hasn't really panned out so far this year. They're 2-5. Went up to Weber last night, lost 6-3 to Weber State last night to move to 2-5 on the season.
It's kind of a unconventional loss for Arizona State. I mean, that's not just saying that. How bad?
Well, there's a lot of turnover too. Yeah. I think there's 16 new guys on this ASU squad. As we see the puck go past the defenseman for Utah, Tyler Riebel, as he goes all the way back. No icing. Now he'll bring it up the near side in the middle of changes for both teams. It's a touch pass by O'Brien. Didn't get enough of it, and we get an icing call on Utah. This comes with 17:07 to go. Here in our opening period, no score between Utah and Arizona State. For as much as we've been talking about the Sun Devils, the Utes, they've done pretty well at the D2 level. Yes, this is their first game outside of the state of Utah, though. They've only played Weber State and Utah State so far.
Yeah, another opportunity to see how you stack up against the rest of the country. I mean, granted, it's at the Division II level, but these are feeder programs. I mean, some of these players you could be seeing at the Division I level in the next couple years.
Yeah, with most of these teams fielding more than one team, especially out here in the West. You see ASU with a couple teams. You see NAU has a couple of teams as well. A lot of chances to promote yourself in, you know, some of these programs out West. Utah trying to field maybe in the works of another team at the D2 level here in the next couple of years. We'll wait and see how that pans out. So we have a 2-on-2 battle in the far corner. Coming out with it was Connor Meany. He pokes it to the top of a point, and his guy Petrie keeps it in. Only for a moment as the Sun Devils clear to center ice. 16:30 to go here in the opening period. No score between Utah and Arizona State. Pass here to the near side. Comes to Alex King. Brings it into the zone. 3-on-2. Now Meany with a snapshot. It's blocked down in the corner by Marcus Velasco. Now here on the near side, West pinches from his point. He holds in the corner, met by the Sun Devils. Three of them down there as it comes to King. Wide open is Petrie. Walking in, a shot. That's saved by Borst. Utes still in control. Dangle wheeling on the far side. Goes top of the point. Cody West now holds. He'll fire a wrist shot blocked in front. Comes to the Sun Devils. Outlet pass finds Scott Farr. By himself one on two, but has help coming. Center pass tipped away. Good play by Petrie. And here come the Utes. Three on two. Dangle, Meany, and Petrie coming in. Dangle over to Meany. Lost it in his feet as he sends one in front. It's stopped by Borst. Pinballing around. Back to Petrie. A wrist shot bounces in front. Borst able to make the save. And he'll hold on with 15 and a half to go here in a period. Utah with a good shift that time.
Yeah, you'll hear coaches talk a lot about going to the net and just getting play to the net. That's a perfect example. It wasn't a good shot going off. It kind of deflected off a skate, off a stick, trying to settle it down, and ended up going on goal and forcing the goaltender to make a save.
So Utah now leading the shot count 3-1 as they win the draw. Barlocker with a shot redirected and held on by Borst.
Borst has some trouble finding that one. All the bodies.
There's been a lot of traffic in front. Utah and Arizona State causing problems for Borst. Oliver 0-1 on the season, just one game for him so far. A 5-1 loss against UNLV 2 weekends ago. As the puck bounces right out in front off the Zamdors, Manzella went out to play it. And a disaster averted for Utah as they now break the puck out. Meyer to the near side, too far for Fornelius to grab. Went after McDonald, he's run into by Fornelius. Backhanded to Meyer through his feet. On the far side now. Lost in the feet of William Corwin. Over down low, the Sun Devils are ringing around here to the near side. Pendle pinches and the hash marks plays it down low. Fornelius off his stick, back to the Sun Devils. Fornelius gets to it in time though as he plays the center pass right to the hands of number 23 in the program. John Godfrey sends one in. Manzella able to easily steer it aside. Utah dodged a bullet there just a couple of moments ago.
It's always interesting rink design just because of where they have to put the Zamboni doors. And you know, we talk about board play, interesting board play. That's, you don't see a bounce like that too often.
Yeah, that tops the list as far as board play there. You have two similar doors on each side. The one on the left side on your up on that far side, a little more jagged than the one here on our right.
Because it opens and closes more often than the other one.
Absolutely. The Utes trying to break out of the zone. Floated pass to the center ice over the stick of Barnes back to the D pair for Arizona State. Cooley gives it here to the near side off the skate of Groskopf. Back to Utah. D to D pass. Up ahead has Sewell at the red line. He backhands it in off the Sun Devil into the zone. Barnes able to tip it away. Now Sewell walks in. Walking in a short angle shot. Just went wide. Rebel unable to hold the zone as he retreats back to his blue line. Plays it to Patrick O'Brien. They continue to play catch with one another. Near side, bound into the neutral zone. Center pass has Reed Hunter making his debut for the Utes tonight. Turnover at the center red line. ASU sends it in. They'll change. 6 minutes gone, or 6.5 minutes gone here in the first period. We've seen chances on both sides. Still no score, though. Puck comes behind the net. O'Brien taps it along. Calix Kingwaite, or excuse me, Ryan Jones here on the near side. Lays a check down, able to break it out for the Utes. Pass to the far side. Too far for Hunter to get. Bounces away from a Sun Devil. Still loose as Jones moves forward. He's bumped off the puck. And it's back to ASU. Pass here to the near side off Johnson's stick. Back is Cody West. Now 7 minutes gone as they gain the red line error. Gosseris will dump it in and go after it. As Borst tried to go on, just played it back behind. Now it's running off the far boards. Dangle keeps it in as the first line's out there for Utah. Top of the point. Here's Petrie walking in a shot. It's blocked at the top of the point. Almost a stretch pass breakaway. And the Utes able to get back in time. Denies the chance. Connor Meany in the zone. Center pass finds King. Lost it as he sends one in front. No one there for Utah to grab it. ASU back out to center ice. A lot of close chances for Utah. It's a good hit over that far side by Aaron Burden. One of the two ASU elite players on this Division II squad for ASU this year. Utah, they've had a couple of chances so far, but nothing's found the back of the net yet, Bob. A
couple good chances, nothing, I mean, that's hockey.
Yeah. You can throw it all kinds of net if you got a solid goaltender.
Yeah, that's hockey.
Not much you're going to do. Center pass finds Connor Meany, gets by one stick. Good poke check, though, from Brian McDonald, but it puts ASU offside, and we get a stoppage of play with 11:51 left here in the first period, a fast-moving first period. Shots 5-1 for Utah. And like I mentioned, the chances have really been on Utah's side. Borst has been solid so far for ASU.
Yeah, and Utah's not only that, but they're stress saves in a way. talk about stress saves, and those are saves that there's traffic in front, there's people in front of you, and you really have to fight to make that save, and that's what Morris over there is having to deal with right now. So good job by him keeping the score equal so far.
Utes win the draw straight and forward. Getting to it first was Corwin for ASU. That's back out to center ice. Austin Mills passing near side, cut off by Cornelius. He tried to center passes off a pad back here to the near side. Cornelius at his own blue line. Floats one near side. Meyer going to try and race after to beat the icing call. He does. He gets to it first. Sends one in front. Cronin can't pull the trigger as he was denied by Mills. Good back check from the forward. Able to deny that opportunity for Cronin, one of the top scorers for Utah.
Good job tying a stick up there.
Three-way tie for the Utes atop the points lead as Alex King, Brett Meyer, and Connor Meany all have 8 points for the Utes. Nathan Kyman, the top scorer for ASU, he also has 8 points. It's Lieberknight with a drive from the red line. Easy blocker save for Boris. Utah in the middle of the change. Bowden goes down, and we get a whistle. May have a too many men on the ice call here.
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
So Utah, or Bonin got tripped up, but it looks like Utah's going to take the penalty. Too many men on the ice as Bonin came straight off the bench. The guy he was replacing wasn't back yet as he made that play. So the Utes take the first penalty of the night with 10:57 to go. And Julian Cronin will come sit and serve the bench minor for Utah.
Got to stay out of the box. That's one of the key things about these Arizona State teams. You mentioned it at the top of the broadcast of being able to play disciplined hockey against Arizona State, especially with all the reincarnation, Frankensteining teams that Utah's played this past month. You got to stay out of the box and play more disciplined than that. Too many men on the ice. The penalty is kind of a joke of a penalty if it gets called on you, because it is real simple to avoid.
Yeah, well, it's the third. I think it's at least the third too many men on the ice call that Utah's had so far this year. The last game that we did here, they had two in the same game. The line changes have been a talking point for this Utah team. The bench minor penalty is to Utah. It's too many men on the ice. Time of the penalty, 9:03 of the first period. And ASU, deadly team, they get their first crack here on the power play.
Talk about patience and being in hustling, hustling off the ice and having some patience to wait for your teammate to get off.
And the Sun Devils send it into the zone, waiting on that far side as Godfrey's tied up. Three Sun Devils, two Utes down in that far corner. Is holding on to it now is Ward. Ward over to Burden. Now top of the point. Back to Burden, far side. Bouncing puck. And King got enough of it. Gets it out to center ice. Burden ahead. He gets tripped up and right to the Utes, who clear. On that divorce, he comes to play. And he'll give it to the far side. Andrew Pekinen will try and stretch pass. It's right to Lieberknight. He sends it in on net. And forcing Boris to make another save.
Was that, how many weird goals have we seen in the NHL in this short, young season? That's not a bad idea.
No, get it on net, good things happen, right?
Yeah.
ASU tries again here on the near side. Velasco into the offensive zone. Back is Utah, though. Pendle gets to it. He tries to clear. It takes a deflection high in the air. Settles around the center circle and all the way down to ASU's end. 40 seconds left here in this power play. That's the halfway point of the first period. Still no score. Stretch pass here on the near side, getting it off the boards is Scott Farr. Farr holds to the hash marks. ASU trying to set up the power play as it's played down low. Looking for a man, gives it back to Farr instead. Holding now, backhands it down low for Kyvan. Kyvan now top of the point, Velasco. Gives it back to Kyvan near side. Holds it as he sends it down low. Mills now, try to go back to Kyvan through his feet. Keeping it in though, Velasco. Back to Mills. Final 5 seconds of the power play now. It's a set one in front. A chance. Redirected and scored through the five hole. A power play goal for ASU. They lead 1-0 with just under 9 minutes to go.
Defensively, I think it was pretty sound. That was a good job there by Arizona State. Just throw it on net and end up with a goal there. Just unfortunate that it went five hole and kind of deflected off of, I don't know if it was the skate or the leg of Manziella, and just found the post and banked in.
Looked like that first opportunity in front was going to be the goal, but it ended up staying out. Either a defensive player, Manziella, made the save, but the second opportunity caught Manziella out of position, and the Sun Devils strike first here in the first period. As Utah trying to gain it back. That's the third time they've hit it into that ASU bench. They're all standing up, whereas Utah's bench, they're all sitting down. So we'll have another stoppage of play.
Let's talk about being engaged in the game. Game right there, goal will do that. You see that Arizona State bench just, you mentioned, they're all standing up over the bench.
ASU wins the draw. They lead 1-0 here. So Austin Mills gets the goal for ASU. That's going to be his second of the season. As the puck pinballs around off of Bowden Skate in front, Morse able to clear it back behind the net. Utah desperately trying to answer the ASU goal here. As here comes Barnes, he'll send it in as they're on the back end of their shift. Morse will collect it, Utah changes up the line. Opportunity for ASU, a stretch pass off the Skate with Groskopf. As here comes Jones in the zone. Poke check to the blue line, stays in though as West brings it along. Went down to 8 minutes to go in the period. And stolen away that time by Beekenen. As it's up over the far side, can't control with Malinowski. Comes back to the Utes. West over the far side, racing after Jacob Cooley. Goes it hard to the near side, just left alone. Gather near side, Wyatt Dotson up ahead, cut in the zone by West, who fires a shot, it's blocked in front by Paikkanen. Big hit by Hunter in front, that breaks out the Utes with King, he'll shoot, and a save by Borst. And a good save from the goaltender, Alex King, the leading scorer for Utah, almost made it 1-1.
Yeah, a great shot there, good idea, but I mean, set up by the defensive play in the neutral zone, just a big hit there, get the puck back. Send it right in the offensive zone and send it on net. Get that goal back. Waking up your bench and make this crowd.
As here comes the Sun Devils. After Utah won that draw, they had stolen away. They gained the red line, sending it in. Is ASU. Tristan Liebernight near side, pokes it along for Meany. Met by the Sun Devils though, stolen away. Here on the near side is Burden. He sends it back down low. Not enough on it as Utah cuts it off. King quickly to the far side. Dangle back down to Meany. 3-on-2 comes the Utes. This is sent in front off the skate of Liebernight. Had room, but the shot just deflected wide. He just tried to redirect that on frame. It didn't miss by much. Here's Dangle on the far circle. A shot. It's saved by Borst.
Again, Utah doing a good job having traffic in front of the net. Maybe getting a deflection. Two opportunities there.
As the Sun Devils look for a change. Near side, Meany has to just tap it along because the pass was off target. ASU was in the middle of a change. Now Utah in the middle of a change. They look here near side. Having trouble with the blue line was Godfrey. Allows the Utes to come back and help out. Tried to stay onside while catching that stretch pass. Back out to center ice now as it's sent right back in by ASU. Utah looks to the far side. Again, looks like just stretch passes here at this point from both sides. Kind of just gravitating from the Utah goal line to the red line. Passing back and forth to each other. Here's Meyer, taps along, has Cronin. Breaking in, one on four though. Cornelius coming in. Shot blocked though. Here on the near side by Velasco. Another try by Meyer. That one blocked that time by Mills. Now it breaks out Nathan Kyvin. Good back check from Cornelius. Able to deny the stick. And now here's the Utes the other way. Here's Cronin. 2-on-4 though. Walking in, this one blocked by Velasco and over to the corner. Picking up now Meyer, trying to walk into the circle. Floats one near side, Petrie will keep it in. Looks for the back door, has his D partner in West. Walks in with a short angle shot, just wide. Now Sam Bowden down low. Rubbed off the puck, still holding onto it. He turns it over as it's floated high in the air. West tried to keep it in, he missed. And breaks out ASU, Garrett Anderson far side. Good check by Cody West. Schools pass off target as the Utes look to break out. Now it's ASU the other way. Floated pass, saved by Manzella. Now Barnes has it. Kept in, bouncing puck towards Manzella. This one he'll cover and settle things down with 4:50 to go. Here in our opening period, Austin Mills' goal the difference so far is it's 1-0 ASU. Although Utah leads the shot count 10-4.
Yeah, Utah without opportunities, but I think one of the good jobs that Arizona State's doing right now is getting their bodies in the passing lane, and it shows them that, you know, Utah could have more shots on goal, but Arizona State has probably as many blocked shots as Utah has shots on goal.
on the far side, collision, two Utes, one Sun Devil, as King now has it behind the net, trying to leave it behind. It's stolen away by Cooley, still bouncing back and forth. Now King has it, centers in front for Dangle, a shot. It's deflected high and wide. Lieber Knight near side, trying to play it for Dangle. It's cut up by a pike in it. He's met by Dangle at the red line, turns it back to Utah. Sun Devil's in the middle of a change as Meany touches it for King. He'll bring it into the zone. Near side circle, trying to leave it for Dangle. He missed on the shot, gets it right back with a backhand. Force makes a save, loose on the doorstep as they still hack at it. And finally, the whistle is blown. A couple of punches thrown on either side, but Borst able to keep it out again.
How did he find that puck in the midst of everything? That's an amazing job there by Borst to find that puck. And maybe a little bit of unlucky for Utah right now.
Just the second start for the Sun Devils, one of the newcomers for ASU, and he's been spectacular here in this first period. Utah with a shot off the draw as Rebel's shot just went wide. O'Brien tried to keep it in on the near side, could not. Pass from Meany off target. ASU able to play it over towards the Utah bench. And again, another puck into the ASU bench from Utah. And we'll have a faceoff at center ice with 3:55 to go.
Get the idea what they're trying to do, bang it off the boards, but poorly executed.
It's too high.
Yeah. Interesting considering how high the boards are here.
Figure skating boards that you see here, there are a lot of figure skating shows here that that have the high boards. Very difficult to jump over if you're hockey player. As ASU wins the center ice draw, we're under 4 minutes now to go here in this game. 1-0 the score.
You gotta have a high vertical jump to play hockey here.
Or at least be like 6'1". Over on the far side, here's Reed Hunter. He passes it to Petrie. Backhands it along. Now here's Jones. Offside as Gostris was too far ahead of the play. And with 3:33, we get another whistle.
Well, if you're taller than 6'3", Coach Christoga might be calling it.
Yeah. Utes ranked 8th in the preseason poll.
Are they?
Yes, that came out today.
So shows you how much I've been paying attention.
No, Jakob Pertl means lots of problems for Utah.
Kyle Kuzma shooting the three, though.
Yes, a couple of solid players for that Ute basketball team. Should be another solid year up on the hill. That loaded Pac-12 conference, Oregon still deadly in that conference. As the Utes set up in the zone. Quick pass, rebound to O'Brien, near side. Wrist shot is blocked, it's right back to him. That was far blocking the shot for ASU. Now pass near side, comes up in front. Cronin didn't get enough on it. Quick eyes of Forrest, able to spot and put a glove on it. We get another stoppage with 3:10 left.
Keep your head up by O'Brien. You got to know that there's a guy that's blocking your shot angle. And you need to delay for a second to see if he'll hold or pass through. And depending on what he does, make your move. But Utah needs to get more quality shots off.
One of the new kids for Utah, Patrick O'Brien, comes from the formerly known as the Salt Lake Moose, now the Utah Outliers, Western States League program. A couple of players from on this Utah squad have come up through that team. Brett Meyer, David Barnes, the other two so far.
Play out in Park City.
4-1 win in the exhibition in that Park City game for the Utes. It's the Outliers trying to make their presence known in the Western States Hockey League. It's the Utes set up here. Good puck movement from Utah. As here's O'Brien. Has time in the slot. That was on his backhand, though. He plays it to Fornelius. Centers in front, two men in there in the front of the crease for Utah, but can't find the stick of Cronin. As Kyvan gets it back out to center ice, Cronin pressuring him, he lost his stick in the process. As ASU back ahead, off the skate, Rebel helps settle it down for Godfrey now. He has an opportunity, throws across for the back door for Mills. Just the pass off target though. That pass also off target for Utah. ASU goes back as the rest of the teams change. Down to the final 2 minutes here of a fast-moving first period as Sewell lays a check on the far side. Utah keeps it in. Barnes able to swat at it as it comes right back out to center ice. Loaded puck gathered by the Utes. Petrie floats one high in the air, bound and tries to settle it. Now he brings it in. 1-on-4. Donovan gets past one, poked right to Barnes. Goes over to the far side. Had Sewell, but he wasn't ready for it. And now ASU 2-on-2 the other way. Shot high this time by Anderson. To bound and quickly out to Barnes over to the far side. Sewell gets to go back for Barnes, but Barnes offside. And a whistle with 1:28 left for the Utes.
Close call there. It is very close, but see a...
Just a little late on the pass.
Yeah.
1:28 to go, faceoff in front of the ASU bench. Faceoff ensues. Back out to, into the Utah zone. King and Mania shot. King, yeah, that time was King. Mania drive deflected high and out of play with 1:19 to go. And this first line for Utah, they've been deadly so far in this first period. There's nothing to show for it yet.
Yeah, a lot of stressful saves there for Forrest in goal. And if you're Brett Hurst, you got to be pleased with it, with at least a first line effort. Getting shots off, getting offensive pressure.
Good. Yeah. Good deflection from Dangle. It's another save for Forrest, though. It comes back to ASU, Will Parlin. Over near to the nearest side for McDonald. He stretches it along. Scotty Farr can't hold on to it. And it's icing on ASU with 1:04 left. So final 64 seconds here of the first period. It's been all Utah for the most part, but the power play goal, the difference.
That's what you get, percent of the puck on net, which is what Utah's been doing a fabulous job of so far in this period. Just unlucky that the goal had a weird, terrible angle, and even a weirder goal as it banked off of Zella.
Normally good power play for Utah, they or a penalty kill for Utah. They give up the goal with only 2 seconds left in it. It looked like they were going to kill that advantage off.
For the most part, it was a great penalty kill, too.
Yeah, they killed about a minute 40 of it before ASU got their chance. Here comes Utah in the zone. Cody West in on the near circle, a shot. Might have took a deflection as it went high. Back down low, final 30 seconds here.
About to stick a McDonald there.
Down low now, Cronin, he pokes it over to Fornelius, has time. He goes for a pass in front. All five Sun Devils were right in front of the net, though. He comes back out to center ice. Final 20 seconds, ASU sends it in. Manzella can't corral it. Ivan couldn't either, now it's back out to Meyer. Meyer into the zone, walking in, toe drag shot, it's wide. And back out to center ice. Utah has too many men again. And they're very lucky they almost didn't get called again. That door on the far side wasn't open. Both defensemen were looking to change. The shot by Sewell is not in time. The horn sounds and just a period of missed opportunities for Utah as they control the first period, but they trail 1-0 Arizona State through 20 minutes.
Yeah, I think you got to be pleased with the effort that Utah gave. It just, you know, that's hockey sometimes. You know, goals squeak in like that, but a great play by Rebo over there not to touch the puck, and great awareness by him to leave that puck alone, not knowing that it's towards the end of the period, and just hold off before you touch that puck. Make sure you do have your five guys before you take it too many men penalty. And a good job there to at least go back into the dressing room, not on a penalty kill coming out in the second period, and only be one goal down. That's I think that's a pretty good way to go into your dressing room and close out the period.
All right, so the Utes trail the Sun Devils by a score of 1-0 through 20 minutes of play. When we come back, we'll have your first period stats and the second period, so don't go anywhere. 20 minutes of the books, ASU leads Utah 1-0 here on Utah Hockey Game Day Live. Welcome back, hockey fans. Getting ready for our second period of the night between Utah and Arizona State. The Sun Devils leading the Utes by a score of 1-0 through the first period. Matt Coma and Baza Chavari here. Breaking everything down, here's your first period. Stats are brought to you by the Utah Sports Commission. ASU had the lone goal in that first period at the 8:58 mark. A power play goal by Nathan Kyven. It's a sixth goal of the season. They ended up giving it to Kyven instead of Mills. Mills does get the assist on the goal. Also, Scotty Farr gets an assist as well. Shots heavily in favor of Utah, though, 14-4 in that contest in the first period. Lone power play went to ASU. They capitalized it with just 2 seconds left. They are 1-for-1. Utah is yet to go on the advantage. They are still 0-for-0. Teams back out on the ice. They switched ends. Utah in the white uniforms move right to left in the second period. ASU in the black and yellow uniforms moving left to right. No penalties carry over in our second period as we get ready to go back underway here. Glad you guys can join us for Friday Night Hockey. Game one of two between these two teams this weekend. Only two meetings between these two teams. We have our puck drop. We're underway for period number two as the Sun Devils win the draw but turn the puck over. Meany had a chance at it. Poked away here to the near side. Back now, a turnover again. King shot redirected in front. Now loose, picked up by the Sun Devils and back out to center ice. Kai Petrie back out for Utah on his own end. As Sun Devils turn over in the neutral zone. Connor Meany now near side. Backhands into the far side. Now ASU goes after it. Jacob Cooley, he turns it over on the far side off the stick of Alex King. Back to ASU the other way, and here comes Scott Farr. 2-on-3 comes the Sun Devils, loose in the corner. Pendle with a good check, able to bump off the puck as he comes near side, off the side of the net, and covered by Manzella for our first stoppage of play here in the second period of play. 1-0 the score, joined by a very special guest here in the Utah hockey booth, former wide receiver for the Utah Utes football team, Kenneth Scott, joining us on the program. Thanks for coming away.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate this.
So I have to ask, as a football player, it's very, we don't really see a whole lot of football players come out to the hockey games.
Right.
Say, what draws you to the sport of hockey?
Well, I have a, it's like an acquaintance that I know on the team, number 19, Petrie.
Okay.
So we're kind of familiar friends, so I was like, you know what, I got downtime, let me go out there and support them. And obviously against a Pac-12 opponent, I want to see them take them down.
Here comes Utah in the offensive zone. Nick Cornelius holds behind the net. It's turned over here on the near side. Utah doing a good job in that first period. They outshot the Sun Devils 14-5 in that opening period. They looked pretty good from that first period from over here. What did you see in that first period?
Yeah, I thought they did really well. I just wish that all them shots, one of them could at least went through. You know, they had a ton of shots around the goal that they could have converted. But it's going to come. I believe it's going
to
come.
Here's a chance in front. Pendle's pass to the far side. It's tipped over to the far corner as Meyer now controls. Over the top of the point. Liebernight just keeps it onside. Now here's Meyer holds top of the point. A lot of traffic in front as he fires a shot. It's blocked and cleared by the Sun Devils. And now a chance. Here's a breakaway opportunity for Austin Mills. Walking in. Good stick flip, but the shot is scored. Five-hole Austin Mills. And ASU capitalizes on another mistake from Utah. They lead 2-0 just 2 minutes into the second. So not the way we wanted to start the second period here.
Right. We got to get back.
So Austin Mills will get the goal. That'll be his second of the season for Arizona State. And not what the Utes wanted. They still lead the shot count 14-5, but they find themselves down 2 here early in the second period. The teams are back out to center ice. We're joined here by Kenneth Scott. Just a hold on there on the far side, almost stuck behind Panzella there. He had to trap for that whistle. You've been a decent time removed from the football team. What have you been keeping up to now that school's done?
Right now, I'm just staying in shape. I have an opportunity to go over to Canada and play in Montreal. So I'm just staying in shape until I head off in April to head over there and play some more football.
Any region in the CFL you're looking at?
It's over there in Montreal.
Okay.
Quebec.
Very nice.
Yeah.
The Alouettes, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
they speak a lot of French over there.
The French Canadians over on the eastern side of Canada.
Yep.
So a lot of hockey fans would know as well. You have Ottawa over there in Quebec, and
yep.
You have Montreal and all the other hockey teams. There's a chance in front off the stick of Bowden and back to ASU. They've had multiple chances to score, but the Utes just haven't found the back of the net yet here.
Yeah, it's going to come.
As The Utes bring it out back out to center ice. They have numbers here on the near side as Barnes lost it off his skate. Brings it in, poked away here to the near side. ASU back in control with Velasco. Pass to the near side off of Anderson's stick. He'll go race after it. Good check by Tyler Rebo, the rookie, with a good hit down there in the corner. Center pass back out. Now here's Bowden, 2-on-2 for Utah. Looks for the far side off the skate of a Sun Devil. Utah in the middle of a change. Another big hit from Gosseris. As the hit's starting to come heavy and often here. As Cody West takes a tumble on the top of the slot, and we get our first penalty of the night on ASU. Here was 16:56 to go, so a chance for Utah to get back in it, try to get this home crowd pumped and back into this hockey game.
Yeah, definitely. I just wish they could capitalize on those opportunities.
So a power play upcoming is it's going to be Velasco to the box for ASU. It's going to be 2 minutes for holding the call. Utah goes to its first power play of the night. So while I have you here, I have to ask a question about the football team. That's your sport. As here comes the Utes, as a shot is blocked in front. That's Petrie. You've had a chance, I assume, to see the football team play so far this year. What are your thoughts on the group this year?
I think they're doing really well, especially on the offensive end. Defense is always going to be stacked. We're always going to have a good defense. But on the offensive end, I think we're doing really good. I just wish we could capitalize on the red zone more. But other than that, I think we're doing solid. And we're going to have it's going to be a fun rest of the season to have a race to the Pac-12 South Championship.
I'd say as a receiver from the offensive side, talking about like the relationship between Troy Williams and Tim Patrick, say you've had a chance to play with Patrick a couple years ago. I'd say it's going to be pretty good as from an offensive standpoint. You got to see them have success like that.
Right. Man, it's good to see, especially with Tim coming back as strong as what he's been doing early on in the season. I like the connection with him and Troy Williams that they got right now. I'm excited for Tim to come back and play. You know, he's been banged up with injuries, but I believe against UCLA, he's going to try it out. And hopefully they do what they was doing earlier in the season.
Oh, it was a stumble there from West. Well, luckily everybody else was changing there as Utah trying to go to work here on the power play. And a couple of shots. Daniels' last shot just went high. As the Utes will try again here. They leave it to Meyer. Walks in. Had a good opportunity, but just missed the far post. There's Lieberknight, down to the far side now. Meyer gets it back to Lieberknight, top of the point. Rashawn off the glove of Boris, back behind the net. Cornelius gets to it in time, trying to step it in front, but it's cleared away by the Sun Devils. Back out to the far corner. Under 30 seconds to go on the power play. Cornelius looks for a pass across the ice. Comes to the top of the point. Barnes a shot. That's blocked and cleared by ASU.
That goalie is having a busy night over there.
Yeah, he's been tested early and often here in this game. Utes just haven't found the back of the net. It just feels like that they just need that one goal and it would open up the floodgates here. A little bit of a turnover back behind as Lieberknight able to leave it for Meyer. Walking in, penalty time about to expire. Meyer in the slot, a shot saved by Morst. Well, on the near side, ASU back to full strength. Looks for the stretch pass, has a man, Velasco. Another breakaway, shot goes wide. Might have got a piece of it, Manzella. Zella able to cut off the angle and force the shot wide. We're back to 5-on-5 hockey here. So the puck goes into the far side. Well, that far side trying to clear it. It's kept out. Bounces in front. Manzella had trouble tracking it. Comes down to Cronin near side. Snatch pass off the skate of Cornelius. Back to ASU. They'll send it back down low. Good check on that far side by David Barnes. Able to knocked the Sun Devil off the puck. That was number 20, Max Bergman. His first touch of the night. And Cornelius weaving through. Gets through one stick check. Racing back, though, is Grant Groskopf as he comes in front. Big hit by ASU. Runs it. Cornelius into the net. And out of play goes the puck with 14 minutes to go here in the second period. 2-0 still the score, but Utah knocking on the doorstep. So we'll let you go back and enjoy the game, but I have to get a prediction out of you for tomorrow, though, before you go.
Oh, man.
How do you think the team's going to do tomorrow?
I say it's 24-20. We're going to win. I believe we're going to have a touchdown thrown within 6 minutes, and our defense is going to stop UCLA from the game.
All right. So we're back underway here on the near side. And we thank Kenneth. Thanks so much for stopping by, and enjoy the rest of the game.
Thank you so much. Go Utes.
All right, Kenneth Scott, former wide receiver for the University of Utah football team, joins us here on the program. Yes, we're back underway. ASU here near side. They send it back down low. Now here's Patrick O'Brien over the far side, Sam Bowden. Leaves it along through Gossers. Monsters into the zone, 2-on-2 comes Utah center in front. Sewell had it on his stick, but tying up by the ASU defense. Break it back the other way. Scott Farr, 3-on-2 for ASU, leaves it back behind. Velasco gets run into by Gosseris. He's shaken up in the corner, able to get back up. It's a violent collision on the far side by the defenseman turned forward, Eric Gosseris. Utes bring it back in the other way. Just caught him up high, a good clean hit. He was in the middle of shooting as Farr will send it back along. As we welcome Boggs back into the broadcast booth. Had to sacrifice the microphone for Ken to come by.
I am glad to do that.
Yeah,
with someone like Ken Scott around.
Absolutely, absolutely.
We had, what, John White here a couple of years
ago? Yeah, John White dropped a puck a couple of years ago here for the Utes. Always love it when the NCAA teams are able to come out and show their support. No, the team has a good relationship with the women's soccer team, the softball team as well.
Yep.
As puck back out to center ice. Here's Dangle walking in, trying to use King as a screen, but the shot was blocked. Comes back to Meany. Utah's been knocking on the door all period. It's been ASU that found the back of the net on a breakaway goal. They've had two breakaways here in this period.
What's about to happen, right? Manziel's first start here, just getting all the weird shots, all the weird bounces.
Yep, he's been tested. Only had 9 shots, but he's been tested. The puck gets deflected up and out of play. We get to stop a play with 12:06 to go here in the second period. We're almost halfway through, and really, it's a weird vibe tonight.
It's like I don't know how you describe it. It's, I mean, Utah's playing great hockey. If you take those two goals out, this is a goal that you showed, like a film that you showed your young players on how to play hockey. Utah standpoint.
That's it. They've been doing things right. They just haven't found the back of the net. And credit Boris. He's been playing well for the ASU Sun Devils here. Here comes Cronin walking in. The shot just trickled on frame. It was kicked aside by Boris. Utah sets up yet again. Petrie to the corner for Meyer. 2-on-2 battle coming out with it is ASU. The pass up the near side for Anderson. Brings it out himself past the red line into the Utah end.
Lively boards back in that.
There's another pair of doors over there, too. Puck squirts out on the far side, keeping it in for ASU is Corwin. High stick played by ASU. We get a stoppage of play with 11:23 to go as it's still 2-0 in favor of the Sun Devils.
Utah not out of it. The way they're working,
no, absolutely
not. The way that they've been doing everything, they are very much in this game. And, like, tell you what, one goal will do a lot for your bench. And mentioned it at the first period with ASU, they're still standing on the bench and Utah's sitting right now, but you get one goal, it rewards all that hard work, and I think that that's all this Utah team needs to start to get going.
All right, hard work just paid off there. They're going to get an offensive draw after sending that one in on net. They're in an offensive draw here with 11:16 to go. I wasn't going to mention this until the third period. The last time these two teams met, they've only met 3 times before. This version of the Arizona State team, they've had Utah's number in this barn. The Utes are 1-2 all time against this team in this barn. Last game was a couple of years ago when this used to be the ASU Pac-8 team, a 2-0 loss here at the Utah Ice Sheet. The Utes couldn't figure out the system that ASU was playing.
Well, I think they figured it out. They just can't figure out the goaltender.
As the puck goes up and out of play off of a stick, 10:52 left to go here. 2-0 is the score. 16-9 is shot count, though. Utah ahead. As we were talking that first period, it was all Utah, but the lone goal came on the power play for the Sun Devils. Utah had a power play to start this period, but they didn't capitalize on it.
Just a couple odd rushes for Arizona State.
Yeah. Had the breakaway out of the box after their penalty expired. That one went wide, though, as Utah, blind pass, almost had Dangle wide open on the back door. Just a little too far forward, though. Now Connor Meany has it poked away from him. Now to the far side, keeps it in the zone. Now back to King. Now low Dangle has Riebel in front. Pinballs around, still loose.
Oh,
jammed in on the near side. It's loose and blown dead. As Borst, I don't know how in the world he saved that one.
Well, it looked like it was sitting right on top of the goal line, and unfortunately, we don't have replay or overhead cameras
to get a good view, or a
net cam.
Like a shortstop stab in the dark on a line drive, he somehow just puts the pad out there, able to just stop it on the goal line. and it stays 2-0.
Unreal.
My goodness.
It's those type of saves. I mean, if you're on the Utah bench right now, you're kind of shaking your head. What do you got to do to solve this goal?
Exactly. What do you have to do to just put one in the back of the net?
That is frustrating.
As Boris D's been playing well. He's only had one game before this one. He mentioned that first period, a 5-1 loss to UNLV. He's looked great so far in this contest. As here come the Utes, looking to try and solve Forrest here. In the offensive zone, loose at the top of the point. It's going to trickle to O'Brien, winds up a shot, score! O'Brien, first goal as a Ute, and the Utes are back in it.
Well, in the words of the great Avon, smack that. That's exactly what O'Brien did. Save the puck.
It's first career point in the college level, and it's his first goal as well, a slap shot drive from the top of the point, and we're halfway through the game, it's 2-1.
That's one of those things, it was a big juicy rebound, O'Brien. It looked like O'Brien hesitated for a second, thought about a passing, he was crashing, and O'Brien decided, hey, I'll just take this myself, and what a spike, I mean, no chance for Boris on that.
No way. Well, we asked what were they going to have to do to solve. Boris just took a drive slap shot from the top of the point.
Yeah.
And a great shot from Patrick O'Brien, his first goal. Get some life in this Ute team as here comes ASU looking for an answer. A shot turned aside by Manziella. Right back to the Sun Devils, though. The shot, save, rebound in front. And Manziella stands tall this time. His first big test of the night. With 9:37 left.
Ryan almost doing his Drew Doughty impression right at the bottom of the U.
It's a great shot.
Ripped.
Just a cannon of a shot.
You feel a breeze coming this morning?
I think so.
A little bit. All
right.
I just wonder if
it's
just me.
Shot, easy save for Manziella. We'll reset again on that far side. That was Grant Groskop on that last shot. So Patrick O'Brien, his first career goal as a Ute. Cut the lead to 1. Hopefully, for Utah's sake, that'll open the floodgates here. As the puck goes off the skate of Meany, no icing as he goes to the far corner. Meany able to shoulder off a man for the puck, trying to bring it towards the front of the net. It's met by Bergman, though, who plays it back to the far side. Loose on the near side now. Meany battling with Bergman as it's just left behind, this time for McDonald. Is the far side turnover. Meany went for the hit into the puck, had an opportunity for his chance. Dead Bergman passes it along. Now Anderson ahead, but he lost it in his feet. ASU will tag up. Utah with a ton of ice to skate with. Here's Cronin, 2-on-2. Cornelius lost in his feet. Backhand save. Rebound, score!
And there it was. We talked about crashing the net. Cornelius, after a couple shifts ago, came off unbelievably frustrating. Because of a missed opportunity. Well, guess what? You give another opportunity, you won't miss it. Did a good job there. Stick handling, digging Boris out of his position and sliding it right behind him for a goal. Get a stop, loving it right behind us.
As the goal from Julian Cronin brings the crowd to its feet, we're tied in just a matter of minutes. Cronin's third of the season, and it's a big one as it's tied at 2. 2 goals in the span of 1:09 for Utah, and we're back to a level hockey game.
That Cronin Cornelius line has been killed the last couple of years. It's showing up here again.
Puck goes into the penalty box here on the near side. Stoppage of play. As soon as we hit the 10-minute mark, it just flipped the switch for Utah. That's 2 good opportunities capitalized by the Utah squad.
Well, that's exactly what you were looking for through that Utah bench. A little bit more life here. More people involved in this game.
And definitely got the crowd back into it.
Absolutely.
Good crowd here for a Friday night. Late contest here. We'll
maybe later tomorrow night.
No, it'll be very earlier tomorrow. We'll be at 7:30 tomorrow. Join us here on the broadcast or join us in person.
Be at the barn.
Come here and support the team. The football team plays at 2. But there's nothing else going on Saturday night. Why not spend it here with the Utes?
Are you not going to be watching the football?
No, I'll be here. Here comes Meyer, a shot forced with the save. I'll definitely have at least a tablet or something streaming it while we're here.
All right.
So at least for our entertainment pleasure, in case the game doesn't work out too well.
I can't
I can't be fully certain I'll be into this fully into this hockey game. I don't have play by play detail tomorrow night.
So. No, that's my cross to bear. But why not come out and support the team? 7:30, these two teams tomorrow night. Tickets at utahhockey.com or at the door. Or join us here on the broadcast. Me and Boss will be here.
Yeah.
Break it all down for you. ASU brings it ahead 3-on-2. Pass here to the near side. Tipped away by Utah, only at the top of the point. Loose down low. Far looks for a man in front over the stick of Ward. Back out to center ice. Burton had a tap up on the delayed offside. Utah on that far side trying to play up the boards. Barnes turns it over as it's back loose in front. Manziel makes a save. It was also blocked. The puck just pinballing around. Now it's a 2-on-1. Loose near side. Big save! Manziel!
How did that not go in? Are you kidding me?
What a pad save from Jared Manziel. He extends across the crease and makes a huge save for Utah.
Oh, man. Unbelievable. You talk about the goal. Great goaltending of this hockey program. I mean, just the names of it. Now you can throw Jared Manziel in this. I mean, we've known the type of goaltender that he was for however many years. We have double minors here.
Yeah, coincidental penalties coming up after that scrum, after the Manziel save. So Aaron Burden and Eric Gossers go to the box. We'll play, looks like 4-on-4 hockey here. Penalties go up on the board with 7:30 to go.
I think maybe just Manziel kind of a little ticked off of that first goal.
I think he's finally found his footing. Is it, as you mentioned in that last period, he kind of got to take a couple shots. It's his first game of the season. Finally found his footing. He comes up big as the puck comes in the ASU bench.
Yeah, that goalie might need his trapper over there.
Other goaltender dressed for ASU tonight, number 30, Jacob Krupp. Ryan Selfreich had the starting on for ASU against Weber State last night. Talking with the coaches, had a little bit of an injury last night. He's not in the lineup tonight for ASU. Turnover now, looks for the stretch pass over the stick of Mills, but they'll beat out the icing call. Manziel quickly out, plays it ahead. Angle to your side, turnover though, Kyven blocks it, 2-on-1 again. Kyven has a man in front, shot, redirected, blocked by West. And trickles back behind the net, another 2-on-1 turnover from Utah, down in their own end. Moves back behind the net. Stole onto his Mills. Looking for someone in front. Has Kyven there. Now comes the point. A shot. That by McDonald. Goes wide. Now over to the far side. A shot from Corwin. Saved by Manziel. ASU controlling the pace here. 4-on-4.
Tough save there by Manziel. He had a lot of traffic in front of him.
Kyven had the man in the back door. McDonald lost it on his backhand. Has to resettle. Left by 2 Utes near side. Pass off target. It'll send it all the way back down. Gives a break for Utah.
Long change here too, gotta hustle on, hustle off.
Both teams in the middle of changes. This one off target. This will be no icing, waved off. It looked like Petrie won the icing call.
Mark's doing a good job hustling there.
And now a 2-on-2 battle ensues. Now Meyer steals it away. The Utes have numbers if they hurry. From the far side, Meany walking in, a low angle shot. Just wide of the cage. And ASU able to chip it back out to center ice. Pendle back for Utah.
Get off finally.
Coming. Yeah, it was out there for an extended period of time. As we're down to 15 seconds in the 4-on-4. Gossers and number 14, Burden. It's a good chance in front. It's pinballs around. Now Lieberknight has an opportunity. Wrist shot. It's blocked.
Be quicker with that shot. Yeah. A little too long.
It's a little too long. Another good chance for Utah as the penalties are over. We're back to full strength. Burden and Gossers out of the box. Far side Belasco, trying to walk by, the backhand shot is wide. Near side now Meyer, can't control, comes to center ice, dodges a check from Barnes. That was Garrett Anderson. Garrett instead of Gary. Another turnover, Sewell, blind shot off the skate of Barnes to the far corner. It's way back behind the net, run hard around the boards, keeping it in O'Brien. He's got the first goal for Utah tonight. The near side, high off the glass. This one will be icy. It's just a matter of time until Utah touches up. They will with 4:50 to go here in the second period. The Utes give up a goal in the first 2 minutes of the period when they storm back with 2 goals in a minute 9, and they have tied this game at 2.
Yeah, not so interestingly enough, they haven't really used the boards a whole lot of board play. They have. It's been weird. A lot of weird bounces.
just been a weird game. That's what I'm just chalking it up to. Doesn't matter what it is, it's just been a weird game.
So it's October games at Utah.
Yeah, it's their only home contest this weekend in the month of October for both these teams. Utah usually playing at home on Halloween. They'll be on the road. They'll be headed to New York to take on Syracuse and Buffalo over the Halloween weekend. Halloween on a Monday, of course. Utes able to send it in there in the middle of a change. Barnes with a wrecking ball in that far corner. ASU still in control though.
Barnes looks frustrated. Maybe thought the defense was getting screened off by yeah.
Kept in by West. He plays it to Cronin, lost it at his feet. Clear near to the near side. Petrie pinching now over his Fornelius as well. Backhanded down low. Cronin able to sidestep Velasco. Nice play. Gives it a Meyer. Short angle shot. Just went wide. Looked for the near post. Cornelius setting up, tried to toe drag through three defenders, poked out to center ice.
He was calling for it.
He was open too. Yep. Bunt comes back into the ASU end, hard off the glass, takes a funny bounce. Cronin keeps it in as he had it in his feet. Now bounces out back to Velasco. He floats it high in the air. This goes wide to Manziel and another icing. It's been a game of streaks here. ASU had a little bit of a run there at the beginning of the period. Utah dominated the middle half. We've seen two other swings before that.
Yeah, and here's the other thing too. Arizona State's on the back end of a long shift, and they just iced it. So fresh line for the Utes coming on, and see what happens here.
First line out there for Utah as they win it back to Pendle. Over to the near side, Dangle lost it off the stick. Trying to ring up the near side, King keeps it in. Now top of the point, Liebernight, wrist shot save. Morris loose near side as Dangle couldn't control it. Quickly over to the far side. Meany shot. Redirecting. Had King on the near side, but a bouncing puck up over his stick. King to Dangle. Back to King with front shot. Save. Rebound. Loose. And blown dead. Another big save from Forrest. Keeps it a tie hockey game.
Huge shoot. That they got the whistle because, look at it.
They were jamming at it.
Yeah, they were jamming at it. This Arizona State team, too, just dragging them off the ice against Utah's top line.
ASU was able to cut it to about a 15-9 shot margin in this period. It's now up to 26-13 for Utah. Since that mark, it's been 11-4, the shot count. Loose in front, Sewell's shot just went wide. Defense for ASU might have had a part in that one.
Utah attacking at point blank range right from the crease.
Here's Pendle, weaving through traffic. Gets to center ice, now finally run into by number 11, Garrett Anderson. He was pressuring him the entire way. Another big hit from Gostris. That's the second one from him tonight as a high sticking call is coming up here. Oh no, it's gonna be a penalty on Gostris for that high hit. Very late, delayed call from Utah, or on Utah. As Ryan Kemp blows his whistle and gives the penalty to Gostris. It's gonna give him a roughing call. And ASU's second power play of the night. They're one for one so far.
Maybe too. It looks like Gosser's left his feet a little bit, so maybe that plays a factor.
Wasn't the charge. He gave him a roughing call.
Maybe
it was a little high. Yeah, maybe hit him a little too hard. So ASU is one for one on the power play tonight. Their lone goal came, or their first goal came in that first period, about halfway through. Came with 2 seconds left in the power play as well, as Utes did a good job killing it off. Now they have an opportunity shorthanded. Here's Meyer. Walking in, has Cronin near side, finds him, shot, just went wide. Now the Sun Devils pull behind their own net and set up the power play break-in. McDonald for ASU to the far side, Velasco tipped it up in the air, almost into the ASU bench, stays in play though. Good check from Velasco on West. It's a low angle try, quick passing, but the shot went wide. Now the Sun Devils set up, top of the point. McDonald near side, Kyvin. Down low for Farr, lost the handle on it, backhanded pass to Kyvin near side. Backhands it to the top of the point, McDonald. McDonald over the far side now. Velasco's shot is blocked over the far side, now back behind the net. Bounces around, back to Utah. West just gets enough of it. Over the outstretched glove of McDonald, clears his own. 1:30 left in the second period, 1 minute to go on the power play. ASU moves forward again. Stretch pass finds Burden. We get a penalty here.
Yeah, I think it might be against Arizona State.
It's gonna be a hooking call on the Sun Devils. That negates the power play as it'll be Austin Mills to the box.
And it was kind of a stupid one. He was with King, and King was just trying to get back on defense and decided to reach his stick out. Brought King down a little bit. Good call there by the official.
So 1:20 left to go here in the second period. We're tied at two. It's a two-minute minor for hooking to Austin Mills. Time of the penalty, 18:40 of the second period. That will negate the ASU second power play. Means Utah, in all reality, they'll have a power play to start the third period here. It'll be an abbreviated one at that. The Utes will have about a minute 10 of power play time once the ASU penalty expires. It's loose in front, almost got to King. And now the Utes set up, top of the point, Pendle. Stick of King, back down low. Played here to the near corner, down to the final minute. King, cross the ice, Lieberknecht with time, wrist shot, Borst makes the save. Holds on with 53.1 to go, 23 seconds left in the ASU minor, or the Utah minor, so Utah will have 30 seconds of power play time, and if they cannot score, they'll have about a minute or so in the third.
And with the way this game's going for Utah, you kind of need to get that at least get some offensive pressure if you're Arizona State right now. So at least get the puck out of your zone.
They have the puck right now as they hold near side. Here's Kyven. The near side. Moves it along for Bergman. Is another big hit. That one for Fornelius. The little guy making his presence known. All that CrossFit that Fornelius does. Making a difference down there in the corner. Bergman trying to get through two Utes, he does, but he lost control of it. The Utes are back to full strength. They have a power play to end this period, only 25 seconds left in it. As Fornelius brings it in, top of the circle, wrist shot, save, Morris loose on the near side. Clear picked up by ASU, backhanded back out to center ice by McDonald. So held on, turnover, back to Bergman, bouncing puck in the neutral zone. Now Fornelius lost it in his feet, Kyven applying pressure. Comes back to Utah. Final 2 seconds and one. That'll do it for our second period of play. So the Utes, they surrender a goal early, but they get both the penalties back, or both the goals back. And we go into the third period, still nothing decided between the two teams.
Yeah, well, number one, a good job by Utah just to get back into this game. And it was exactly what Utah's been doing all game. They just somehow found the back of the net. It was actually not somehow, but on two great opportunities, one by O'Brien, the other by Cronin. And just being in the opportune moment, putting the puck on net, forcing a huge rebound on one of them. The other one, a big hit, caused another offensive opportunity. And this is what Utah hockey is about, what they're known for. And, of course, third period coming up, got to go out and get the win as we come back. So good job there by Utah. Got to be happy with everything that's happened in the second period aside from that early goal.
All right, so strap yourselves in, folks. We'll be in for quite a third period here. Nothing decided between the two teams. We're tied at two through two. You're looking at Utah hockey. Game Day Live will be back in about 15 minutes with your second period stats and the third period. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Utah hockey, Game Day Live. fans, getting ready for our third and final period of the night on a Friday night here in Salt Lake City. Matt Coma, Boz Echevarri here. We're tied at 2 through 40 minutes of play. And Boz, everything to play for here in the final period tonight.
Oh, absolutely. And here's the thing. Utah's been playing great hockey, but they've had a battle to get back into this game after being down 2-0 at basically the start of the second period. And they've done a good job, in, especially late in the period, getting it, like staying in their offensive zone, applying a whole lot of great pressure. I think this is exactly where, of course, Utah would want the lead, but you got to be happy with the position you're in.
Here's your second period stats brought to you by the Utah Sports Commission. We're tied at 2 as ASU, as Boz mentioned, scored very early in that first second period, 1:51 into it, as Austin Mills scored on a breakaway goal. Godfrey gets an assist along with Corwin at the 1:51 mark, made it 2-0. But for Utah, two goals in a span of a minute 6. As Patrick O'Brien scores his first collegiate goal, assisted by Fornelius and Cronin. Cronin gets a goal off of a nice pass from Fornelius, his third of the season, assisted by Fornelius and West. So 2 point nights for Cronin and Fornelius so far. Utah shoot the Sun Devils 13-11 in that period. They now lead the shot count 27-15. Arizona State 1-for-2 on the power play. Utah's 0-for-1, but they have 40 seconds of power play time to start our third period here tonight. Teams go back to their original sides. Utah in the white uniforms will move left to right. ASU in the black uniforms moves right to left. So you'd start with 40 seconds of power play time here as Mills is still in the box. Teams meet at center ice, getting ready for our final period of the night. Puck drop, we're underway as Utah wins the opening draw. D to D pass, Cody West, hard around the boards with that fresh ice. Ringing around near to the near side for Meany. Going now, here's King walking in, now back behind the dangle. Tries to go in front, it's loose on the top of the crease, and Borst, who's been very busy all night tonight, makes another save.
In theory, it's a little bit harder for goalies to make these top scores. You don't have that snow buildup in the crease.
No.
So if you're Utah, this is the time of the period to go get those clean shots off.
Well, you saw it from dangle there, is he just threw it in front because you know it's going to pinball around with the fresh ice. He'd set up the power play. Here's West through traffic, rings around at King here on the near side, but couldn't pull it to his forehand, and it's tipped out of play. 19:29 to go, 9 seconds remaining in the power play here. Good puck movement from Utah, almost getting a good chance on net. Just seems like the puck has just been off the Utah stick so far over the first couple periods.
Just off the tape.
Pucks back out to center. Nice good defense from ASU to deny that chance. We're now back to full strength as King brings it along. Into the zone. Tries to leave it for Dangle. Short angle shot. And the open near side corner, but just missed it. ASU in the middle of a change. They're trying to solve their lines after the penalty kill. Now King tipped in front by Dangle. That just went wide. Wraparound try, score! Josh Dangle gives Utah its first lead of the night.
Of course, no chance on that. I didn't even know where the puck was after. There. I shouldn't say easy, but Dangle just being quick about it, getting the puck around and sliding it home. No chance.
Unfortunately for Boris, no chance, but fortunately for the Utes, it's their first lead of the night. Josh Dangle gets the goal. It's just his third goal of the season. And the Utes, just a minute into this third and final period, they have their first lead of the night. Very much like the Utah State home opener game. Back in September, the Utes had to wait all the way to the third to take the lead in that one. They do it again here against the Arizona State. Now the Utes looking for more. Cronin shot, blocked, top of this point. Cornelius has it poked away. Beavernight able to steal away from far, loose on the far side. Meyer chips it along, loose near side. Now Cornelius, nice toe drag, walking in, a shot saved by Boris. Cleared out of the zone by ASU.
5-hole was open too. There was a daylight.
Little patience from Cornelius on that one. It was just waiting to pick his spot, almost put it back home. It's loose here on the nearest side. Cornelius along, too far for the outstretched stick of Meyer. Back out to center ice. Only now his own blue line, Andrew Pikin, and he hasn't been called in quite some time as he turns it over in the neutral zone, not sent back in towards the ASU end.
Almost could have been too many men there. Yeah.
Both teams in the middle of changes there. It's sending it hard off the boards is Jacob Cooley. ASU wanted to change. They will, and it's going hard into the boards. He was battling with O'Brien for that icing call. number 17, Grant Groskopf. That went hard into Manzella. The two guys were racing side by side for that icing call. ASU won it. Face-off upcoming in the Utah end with 17:45 left. That goes off. Those Wiley pegs that they have in the...
well, it's a good thing they have those. I mean,
well,
like,
it's a new technology, yeah. Too. So it's not the normal for people who play men's league or adult hockey or played youth hockey. You have those metal spikes that usually go in.
Yeah.
Then you have the moorings that you usually see at the NHL level where they actually drill a hole in the ice and will put the pegs in. These ones are kind of a cross between the two. They have a soft upper end but a hard anchor to it. So it's meant to be easily bumped off, but it's also when a goalie's sliding back and forth able to not knock the net off, which we saw in the Wasatch Cup 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Where the net just keeps getting larger. So in front, a shot, and it's saved by Boris right in the bread basket. It's Jack Sewell had a great opportunity presented to him right in front.
Good forced giveaway there by Utah. And
almost
Brian
disaster.
We need him.
Sewell looking for his first goal of the season on that last opportunity. We're down to 17 and a half. It's Petrie with a drive. It's right into the shins of Michael Cullen. Now he races back after. Petrie able to steal it away from him. He has it back behind the net. He'll bring it out himself. Has time to skate it. He passes it near side up in the air off of his stick. And he can't get to it in time. It's back to Arizona State. Pass behind Cullen. Back to Petrie. D to D pass to West. Back across to the far side. Angle on the blue line, good poke check from number 18, Andrew Pikenin. As now Dangle is not able to hold off Pikenin's check. It's a shot by Meany. Almost found its way through the wickets, but another save for Forrest.
Forrest making a tough save there. Was screened off by Cooley. Good job there by King to get on the shot.
I think it was Dangle that got
the
shot.
Yeah. Good job there. See the open lane between the wickets and man.
Say Oliver Boris, his second appearance of the season, has been spectacular for Arizona State. 27 saves on 30 shots so far. And Zella's given up two on 13 shots. As Cornelius, center pass, back to Cronin, gives it to Meyer, past the blue line, they stay on side. Now walking in, all five Sun Devils are down low, below the hash marks. Well, they tried to send one in front there.
And they've been like that for most of the game. A lot of the opportunities Utah had early in the game, they came from their perimeter type shots. They weren't shots in the slot. They weren't shots in between the dots. They were outside shots that had to get through traffic. And that was really the main reason why Utah was kept off the scoreboard for as long as they were.
Yeah, a lot of traffic in front makes it hard to find the just even get it to the goaltender, let alone the back of the net.
Double-edged short sword there.
Yeah, you give up a lot of space in the zone, especially on this Olympic ice. Arizona State used to the NHL size back at Oceanside Arena. The newly renovated Oceanside Arena as well, with the NCAA team making some adjustments. As the puck is shot from the point, it's blocked and settled by Utah.
It's the program you want to play for, the program you want to become, depending on what side of the line you look on.
Another shot from Sewell is saved. Barnes has one in front. Gosseris! It forces Force to make a big save. It's still loose down low. Picked up this time by Barnes. Looks for the wraparound. Didn't have enough on it. Now it comes to Sewell. Tries to turn around a shot. It's loose in that crease again.
Foster trying to stick tight.
Yeah, this time picked up by ASU. Now 3-on-2. The other way they just send it in. Just everybody just tying each other up in front there. Completely legal play for both sides.
Smart play.
Pretty much the only play you have when you're down when you're down low like that. It's a back turnaround, backhand shot. That time by Aiden Ward is turned aside by Manzella. Now it's 3-on-2 for Utah. Moving in with speed, Meany. Leaves it for King. Walks in a shot. Force got a piece of it.
Nagel looked like he's trying to shoulder that one in a little bit.
Yes, it looked like an easy chance for Utah. As a shot on the point off of Meany. Loose in front at King. But couldn't find him as it went off an ASU stick. They'll just chip it along, try to change. Lots of open ice, but the pass off target. No icing as Meany will beat it out as Petrie just missed on that stretch pass.
I wonder if Petrie thought that Meany was screaming down the ice, because the way that he passed it, it looked like he thought
he was already there.
Yeah.
Utah with a strong shift here as it comes to the top of the point. Petrie thought about a shot, instead gives it back down low. King will get to it first. He leaves it for Dangle. handled, stolen away by ASU, but another turnover. Now, Meany turnaround shot, deflected out of play after the save by Borst. 14:31 to go in the contest, 3-2 Utah. Yeah. Engel's goal, the difference so far.
Right now, this pace is completely furious from Utah. They're just getting after the puck, getting after the net, trying to put this game away.
Got to figure now is when the altitude starts playing a factor for this team.
Yeah.
Second day at altitude after playing Weber State last night.
Look at the weather too. It's been seasonably.
It's been normal. Yeah. It's actually been above normal for October in Utah.
Still cold though. You got to adjust.
Usually we see some snow by now, but it's been in the 60s. And the diving poked a good effort from Meyer on that last opportunity. Almost got it to Fornelius, who was waiting on the back door. He battles with two Sun Devils down there. Cronin helping out as well. Trickles out to Malinowski. On top of the point, Riebel, a shot turned aside by Borst. It was loose on the doorstep. No one there for Utah as ASU sends it all the way on net to Manzella. Loose down low, Gostris. A little shoulder off a man, gives it to Cronin in the corner. Now he'll chip it high in the air over the stick of ASU, but Fornelius beats out the icing call. Good speed from the forward. Sends one in front, had Gostris, but had to deal with three Sun Devils. Comes near side. Poking in along is Dodson. Stolen away, though, by O'Brien. Back up to the near side. Gostris at the red line. Now the blue line sends it in. Barnes chases after. Barnes in front. No one home as the Utes were changing.
Good idea there, however.
And the Utes have just been fractions away from really opening this game. As this puck will go all the way down, this one will be icing. And we can stop the play with 13:01 to go here in this contest. Utes doubling up, the Sun Devils on the shot count now, 34-17, but they only lead by one.
Well, and that shows the type of defense that Arizona State's been playing.
What's that condensed defense we've been talking about? They don't allow a lot of shots on net.
Well, the thing too, like even late in this period, they're still getting in passing lanes, they're still getting in shooting lanes. Learn a way to control an offense, that's all you really need to do.
Here's Dangle walking into the slot after just weaving through defensemen over on that far side. Trying to pinch was Pendle, he missed the puck and he comes back out to center ice.
Of course, Utah doing a good job skating the puck.
Turnover, Meany had King towards the Utah end. Now good passing, here's Meany, top of the slot, a shot saved by Borst. Back into the Sun Devils possession, biking it. Bumped off the puck. All three forwards over there for Utah stealing it away. Trying to go to Dangle. Went off of his stick to the far side. Still loose on that far side. Now a turnover. Wide open. 2-on-0. Dangle. King score! Alex King. He puts it home. 2-goal lead for Utah.
Great save. Again, no chance for the forwards. A 3-on-0 situation. And yeah, as a goaltender, kind of hope that you guess right. Borst gets wrong, and it was a clinic on tape-to-tape passing and how to run a 3-on-0 offense.
A 2-on-0 proved to perfection on that one. Could have been, it was a 3-on-0 in all intents and purposes. And the Utes lead 4-2, as you see on the shot sheet there, 12:20 to go. And the Utes, took them a while, but they finally have taken control of this one. Here's another two, maybe 3-on-1. Meyer over to Fornelius, bounces to Cronin, just gets in a piece of it. Was Borst just off the tip of his glove.
Okay, that's another good opportunity next to us.
He's been going nuts since the Utes have been showing him and the rest of this crowd a good time here so far tonight. As a shot, this one from Pendle redirected on net, and Borst on the good positioning, able to make the save.
I'll tell you what, man, this goalie Borst, he's making saves that are just blowing your mind, man. Like,
he's been solid.
He doesn't, like, this last save, he didn't know he even had the puck, man. I mean, that talks about good positioning out of goaltenders. I mean, Forrest doing a great job in that, keeping Arizona State in, but, man, unbelievable.
So 4-2 now the score. The win by Meyer almost to Crony. He kind of pinched in a little too far. Now breaks ASU out. Here's Farr. Has a man in front. Now looks for the man supporting him. It's a shot that time by Ward is blocked. Opportunity for ASU on that opportunity. Pass over the far side. Cronin just trying to tap it along. It's kept in by ASU. Shot from the point and saved by Manzella. Now Cronin far side. Lost it in his feet. Still loose. loose on that far side. Three Utes, two Sun Devils there. Sleeper Knight trying to use his size and body to try and clear the zone. He could not. It's kept in. Ward met by two Utes, able to play it down low. It's far. Gave it to Ward, but he turned it over. And now breaks out the Utes again. 2-on-1. Meyer with Fornelius. This one, Meyer will shoot. It's saved by Borst. As man breaking in with Sewell. Turnaround shot. Redirected just wide. Still bouncing around. Comes back to Sewell. Up in the air and back to the point. Rebel fans on the bouncing puck. And back out to center ice. Crazy sequence of events in front of the ASU net yet again.
It looked like it went off the heel of a stick there. That's why it looked so weird.
And the puck goes off of Gosseris and into the ASU bench with 10:38 left.
Look at that linesman over there. He's been in a lot of plays. It's like a big red target on the inside of the ACHA patch.
Face off over on that far side. Gosseris will go against Bergman this time. It's won by the Utes. To the point, a shot. That one from Rebel is blocked. Now Sewell down low for Gosseris. Walking in, backhand, has Barnes in front, but long jam of Black down there though.
What a cheeky attempt from his
another opportunity. This one by Anderson is denied by the Utah defense. It's over on the far side now. ASU keeps it in. Rebel up along. Sewell floats it high in the air over to the center ice. Bouncing puck. Barnes trying to get through three defenders. Finally settled by McDonald. Pass up ahead. Turnover though, and here comes Alex King with Dangle. 2-on-2. Back to King, a shot, and forced yet again up to the task. Denies a rebound opportunity and another whistle with 9:57 to go. We're past the halfway point. The Utes have two goals here in the third. Dangle and King, your two goal scorers, they lead 4-2.
Looks like there before is doing a good job getting in position again. Got the battle's goaltender, good positioning.
Faceoff on the far side is won by the Utes. Petria drive took a deflection wide. It's over near side. Malinowski gets it out to center ice. Cody West waiting at the red line. He sends it back in. It's gathered by Paikkanen. Now ASU ahead over on the far side. Stolen away, but right to Cullen. Backhands it down low. Back to Dodson now, battling with Petrie. Dodson in front of the man. Shot, save, rebound, another save for Manzella. Stands tall. Now it's 2-on-2 the other way. Meeting with Dangle. King joining the play. Dangle, turn around, score! Just a toe drag and a shot on the ice. Forrest knows he should have had that one with 9:22 to go. It's 5-2. Angle two goal game for him now.
Yeah, Velasco just had it work with him after that. Well, I mean, that's tough too. Like, let's just say that Morrison normally makes him sleep. And just.
Well, there was a screen in front too. Yeah. Again, gotta give him a little bit of credit, but. Dangle just using that finesse game to his advantage and puts another goal ahead. Now 5-2 to score. Yes. Huge three goals here now in the third, all by the first line. As Dangle has two, King has one. Any of the little guy yet to get on the score sheet for Utah on that first line as the puck rings around and is to be icing on Utah. And we get a whistle with 8:54 to go in this contest. The Utes all over ASU here in the third period.
That's how the first period went, just about the goals.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what it was, so.
The Utes have been in control since the get-go. ASU's had flashes of brilliance here and there. The two goals by Kyben and Mills, one on the breakaway, one on the power play, have really been all ASU's had. That's not to credit Manzella either. He's had to come up a big a couple times.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's been all Utah here, as you would expect, and we get a whistle and a penalty upcoming. It's going to be a cross-checking call, which means it most likely is on Utah. And it is Tristan Lieberknight to the box. So as much as we've been saying about Utah to dominate this thing, the Utes just gave the Sun Devils the biggest present they probably can, a power play here to try and shift the tide here.
Yeah, three-goal leads, too. I'll tell you, it's the most dangerous one in hockey, especially the way the game of hockey is being played right now. And You still got to, you looking at this game too, this is a game Utah's playing that a Division I team should have against a Division II team.
Shot off the draws, just wide.
Just not having the results entry. And that's what this game's kind of coming down to. I think Utah's played a marvelous game. It's, they're playing Division I hockey. That's,
as we've been talking about, the ability for this team is a shot deflected up and loose and covered by Manzella. Stoppage of play, but the ability of this team not to overlook the Sun Devil team. Yes, it's a D2 game, and you have a big weekend next weekend against number 2 Minot State. It's not, you can't overlook this team. You have to come in, you have to play two games, and take care of business here at home.
Yeah, absolutely. And if you play a game like this the way that you're playing right now against Minot State, you're in a good position, especially the games that you have played against the ranked teams in Division I. There's nothing to be ashamed of in taking those two losses. You just got to put the puck in the back of the net on the opportunities that you get. That's what hockey's about, is converting the opportunities that you have. The team that does that more often is going to win the game.
So the Utes are on the kill here as they play a D2D pass and clear it down the ice. We're down to a minute 20 left in the power play. The penalty was to number 7, Tristan Liebernight. 2 minutes for cross-checking. Call just the third power play of the night for ASU. They're 1-for-2 so far. Utah's 0-for-2. We haven't seen a whole lot of penalties in this one. Puck floated in. Manzella steers it to the corner. O'Brien first one there. And gives it to Dangle. 2-on-2 if the Utes want it. Here comes Dangle. King racing hard. Good poke check from far on the far side as a forward. Back checking for Utah. But now Alex King has time in the slot. Shot save. Rebound at Dangle. But couldn't hold on to the puck as he gets his stick slashed out of his hands. And a penalty coming for ASU as they meet at the Utah blue line. Dangle draws the call and will play 4-on-4 yet again. Scott Farr heads to the box.
And characteristic of Farr taking that kind of penalty.
Just kind of hacked the stick out of his hands, and the slashing call to Farr. We'll play 41 seconds of 4-on-4 before the Utes will go on the power play for their third time. They are 0-for-2. So ASU officially 1-for-3 now on the man advantage. And the Utes win the draw. 4-on-4 hockey here as West gives it to Barnes. Loose in front. Backhand. Save again. This time by Borsta, able to hold on to that puck.
Borsta doing a good job getting big there, just taking away the angle. The bigger you get, the harder it is to get past you. Manziel doing that on the other end.
Able to stand tall. As the Utes, another turnover. Barnes again, the backhand. It's saved again by Borsta. That's the third backhand in about 10 seconds for Barnes. Then he's had an opportunity on him. Borsta saved all three. I know we're a Utah broadcast, but I am a big fan of Oliver Borsta here.
I am too. If we didn't have the great goaltending that we do here at Utah, I'd say make a trade for him.
Oh, we say we are spoiled here at the U. Three solid goaltenders in Coma, Manzella, and Patrick Casper, who we may see make his collegiate debut tomorrow, depending on what the coaches want to do after tonight's contest. Coma's out for the weekend. He's resting up for the next weekend. He's played all 8 games going into tonight. Just the 4th start of the season for Manzella, of his career for Manzella tonight, I should mention. It's 2-1. Another stretch pass breaks out the ASU on the breakaway. Another save by Manzella. He's been standing tall, able to deny Burden on that one. Utes on the power play now for a minute 5 as Barnes has it, plays it across the ice to West. West walks in, a shot again held on by Borst. And he'll hold on with 6:24 left in the game, 1 minute to go on the power play. And the Utes about, I would say about 4 more minutes away from sealing this one up.
I'd say 6:24.
It's 6:24, a lot can happen at 6:24. Just saying.
There's a lot of things that can happen in the span of a minute 29.
I saw the Utes score twice in a minute 6 in the second period, so anything can happen. As the Utes unable to hold the zone, Petrie will ring it around the boards. Waiting on the far side is Dangle. Tied up by McDonald, he's able to steal it away. And over the far side, off the stick of Corwin. Now back near side, poke to the top of the slot. A lot of people up there as West will fire a shot. Deflected over the far side. Cullen trying to clear the zone, cannot. West able to keep it in, gives it to Dangle. Utes set up once more. West comes center, gives it to Dangle, far side. Top of the circle. Back to West. Playing catch over on that far side. Now West again through traffic block. King almost had it settled to his feet. And ASU got able to get a stick on it. I think Cullen able to send it all the way down for Arizona State. Final 10 seconds of the power play. Here is the Utes with a stretch pass to Connor Meany at the red line. Trying to float a pass. Petrie settles one that's bouncing in the air. Turned around as Cronin now has it. He sends it into the ASU end. UD pass now Velasco. Into the near side, over the stick of Petrie, Lieberknight back for Utah. We're coming up on 5 minutes to go in the game. It's breaking out. Cornelius looking for the stretch pass, finds Cronin. Walking in, low angle as he comes in, but good defensive play by Parlin. Able to steer it aside. Utes still in control, Lieberknight leaves it for Pendle. Pendle down to Cornelius, walking in, now back behind the net. Now gives it to Meyer, lost it in his feet. Blown away by Arizona State. Burden now moves it ahead, rest of the line changing, so it's 1-on-4, and he gets hooked to the ground by Cornelius. And another power play for Arizona State upcoming with 4:36 to go.
Well, kind of a little bit undisciplined there, and that's one of the things that Cornelius knows that, shaking his head as he comes off the ice.
Yeah,
but one of those things that you gotta stay mentally in the game, even though you do have a three-game lead. The Cubs might have a three-game lead tomorrow night.
Oh, don't even bring up the Cubs. So the penalty is a high-sticking call to Nick Cornelius. That's the official call. As Arizona State's fourth power play now begins. They're 1-for-3. DD pass. Velasco through traffic is wide. Over the far side now, Mills. Gives it to Kyvin. Back to Mills, far side. Has a wheel around the circle instead. Backhands it back to Kyvin. Kyvin top of the point. McDonald walking in, back to Kyvin. Now back to McDonald. Top of the point. A shot saved by Manzella.
Just aggressive move there at the top of the paint.
Now Velasco settles it down here near side. ASU back in control. Near side, far. Far will leave it for Kyvin. Stolen away by Riebel as Far now helps out, able to keep it in possession for the Sun Devils as it comes to the point. Velasco. Is it just on sides? It's played down low. No one there for ASU. O'Brien gets to it in time, and he's able to clear. Quick play by Borst as the Utes are changing. Here's Scotty Farr. He holds in the corner, pressured by Petrie. Squirts out right in front. As Ward now has it. And ASU sets up again. Back to McDonald. Over to Ward. Walking in, West got a stick in the way, back into the corner now. Down low, looks for Kyvin in front, bounces out to Ward, loose in the top of the slot, and another save for Manzella. Kyvin has it stolen away by West, it's cleared out to center ice. Meany will pressure the Sun Devil defense. Only for a short time as Ward will send it to the near side. Velasco all the way around. We're down to the final 30 seconds of the power play as Lieberknight holds. Turnaround shot, good picket. Good pocket pick from number 14, Burden. But the Utes able to dodge another bullet, they clear. Lieberknight got his pocket pick. That's what I was trying to say.
You had your mouth picked.
I'm saying, vocabulary is key for broadcasters. Sometimes it just doesn't come out in the way you want it to. Finally, time is up. Cornelius out of the box with 2.5 to go here, as it looks like now the Utes going to be on their way to their fifth victory of the season. They'll move to 5-4 on the year. They'll take on this ASU club tomorrow night. And here comes Meyer. Has Cornelius in the back door, but it takes a deflection off of an ASU skate. Rear to the near side. Cornelius keeps it in, throws it on frame. Borst has to make the save and cover.
Thought about it for a second.
Thought about playing it, but had Meyer approaching quickly, had to make the save.
Wisely made the save. Yeah, absolutely.
5-2, your score, 2:10 left in this contest. The two teams will go back at it again tomorrow night. I hope you can join us, hopefully here in the barn at 7:30.
You never know who you're going to see at the barn.
Yeah, you could see Kenneth Scott like we saw today.
Yeah.
Thank him for joining us on the broadcast for a little bit, coming out to support the Utes.
Hey, for all we know, Kenneth Scott could be a season ticket holder.
Yeah, who knows? We thank everyone for joining us either here on the broadcast or here in person. A good crowd tonight. Hope we can make it even bigger tomorrow. Game time's at 7:30 tomorrow night. Utah and Arizona State wrapping up the weekend and the season series between the two teams.
Last home game of fun.
Yep. Utes won't be home until November 12th after tomorrow night's contest. It's Barnes weaving through. This was on net, of course, though. 1:33 left on the clock. Utes' upcoming schedule after tomorrow night, the Utes will head to Minot, North Dakota.
That'll be a fun one.
Next weekend, yeah. Number two Minot State, a pair of games. Utes, they will love a result or two from that weekend. Try and maybe propel them into the rankings.
Yeah.
Top 20, along with the auto bids, get to Nationals. They still haven't been in the polls yet. There's Dangle. Dangle holding firmly on that far side. Brings it center, now gives it to Pendle. Pendle back to Dangle, walks in for the shot to the far post, just a little high. King down low, gives it to Meany, tries to float one back to King. It's denied by, again, five Sun Devils below the hash marks, and now here comes Velasco. Velasco with speed, short angle shot, turned aside by Manzella. We're down to 1 minute to go here. Dangle in the slot, he'll shoot, Force makes the save. And holds on with 55.7 to go here.
Well, it's all but academic now.
Yeah. Weekend after Minot for Utah, they go to the East Coast for the first time. They'll take on some of the New York clubs. Up in Buffalo, the upstate New York teams go to Syracuse and Buffalo in 2 weeks. As we get a stoppage play with 49.5, hand pass the call on the ice.
Should be a fun trip.
Oh, yeah.
And here's the thing, too, about those long road trips. You actually got to see what your team really is made of, especially against East Coast teams. But not only that, like, it's a great way to build team chemistry, honestly. Probably some of the most fun I've had were those road games.
Absolutely. These guys, more team bonding for them is 14 hours away from them next week. That's just one way. As they go to Minot, North Dakota. They've already been to North Dakota once already. They took on Jamestown a couple weeks ago. They'll drive a little farther than the one they'll have to Minot.
Stupid.
The Utes holding near side, only 25 seconds remaining in this one. As the Utes gonna skate to 5-4 here. They're back to 500 for the first time since September. They continue their perfect streak against the D2 teams. They're 5-0 now against Division II clubs. Still looking for that first win at the D1 level. Hopefully this weekend will build some confidence for the Utes as the horn sounds to wrap up a Friday night in Salt Lake City. The Utes come back from down 2-0 in the second period. 5 unanswered goals. They win 5-2 here on a Friday night.
Yeah, great effort here from Utah. I mean, really, they played 3 periods of hockey. They didn't get the result in the first 22 minutes of the game, but they did play a very good hockey game that you got to be proud of the way they played all 3 periods. Fundamentally sound, just got to learn how to stay out of the box and not give other schools opportunities to beat you like that. But this was a great, well-played game from the University of Utah. And you should be proud. You're right back at it tomorrow. So work on those mistakes and really have a better result tomorrow night than you did tonight. That's what the sport's all about.
So the Utes get at their 5th win of the season. Jared Manzella, first start, first win for the sophomore for Utah. Picks up the win with 25 shots on goal, 23 saves. Solid night for the goaltender. And we were talking in that third period, the goaltending has been superb across the board for Utah and Manzella. Just another example of how great this goaltending core is.
Yeah, absolutely. And it just shows you, like, this program has had an awesome history of great goaltending, and that's exactly what we've seen tonight. And you got to be proud of that. And we'll see the same kind of show tomorrow night.
All right. Well, we ask you guys to join us in person tomorrow night. If you can't, join us on the broadcast. Me and Boz will be here at 7:30. Time to wrap up the season series between the University of Utah Skating Utes and the Arizona State Sun Devils. 5-2, the final score here. Utah moves to 5-4. The Sun Devils now 2-6 on the season. That's going to do it for us here on a Friday night. For everybody here with Utah Hockey, for Boz, I'm Matt Coma. We'll see you again tomorrow night at 7:30 for the weekend finale. You've been watching Utah Hockey Game Day Live 5-2, the final score. Have a great rest of your Friday night. We'll see you tomorrow.